Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Rice is one of the most widely consumed foods in the world, and its demand has increased in recent decades. If it were a song, it would be in the top 10 list. Oftentimes, to improve its production and yield, the use of various pesticides during cultivation has increased. But due to the adverse effects of these pesticides on human health and to the environment, the use of these pesticides must be controlled and monitored. In this episode of Behind the Science, let's go grocery shopping and take a look at different rice, including organic, and see if there is a difference in pesticide content. Dimple, just the person I was looking for. So I was at the grocery store and I never realized how many different types of rices there were. I was wondering if you can give me some more insight into which rice I should choose, maybe based on some pesticide work you've been doing.
Yes, Jen, there are different types of the rice. As you can see, jasmine rice, basmati rice, brown rice, and depends on where they're grown, they may contain different pesticides.
So this one says that it's organic. Does that mean that it has no pesticides?
Not necessarily, Jen. Let me show you. You may have seen various claims on organic products, such as 100% organic, organic, made with organic, specified organic ingredients. 100% organic means all ingredients are organic and certified. Organic label means all agriculture ingredients must be certified organic except where specified on national list. Non-organic ingredients allowed per national list and may be used up to 13% of content. Made with organic means at least 70% of the products must be certified organic ingredients. And specified organic ingredients means multi-ingredient products with less than 70% certified organic content.
So interesting, Dimple. All right, so let's test this organic rice. Where's your instrument?
Whoa, Jen. You cannot directly analyze these under the mass spectrometer. You need to do sample prep for that. So you need to homogenize the rice and then sample prep and bring it into the vial. And these you can analyze on a sensitive mass spectrometer.
Great, can you show me?
Sure, let's go. Two basmati rice and one organic brown rice were analyzed with this method. The one that was labeled as organic brown rice was found to have low but detectable levels of two pesticides, pepronyl butoxide and imidacloprid. This example shows pepronyl butoxide detection in rice samples. The USDA National Organic Program includes a list of synthetic compounds that may or may not be used in organic crop production. This list does not include pepronyl butoxide or imidacloprid. The pesticides detected, however, were not at concentration that exceed the US FDA or the EPA regulated tolerances, and as such, no action level has been exceeded.
I never knew there were so many pesticides that could be used during rice production. Good thing we have a powerful LC-MSMS rock band. Combined with simple sample preparation, we can screen for more than one pesticide to get a true picture of what's going on. If you would like to know more details on the method we described, we have an app for that. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition.